In today's video, I'm going to show you a VBA function that lets you check whether a file or folder exists. The function that lets us check for the existence of a file or folder is the DIR or DIR function. Now, this function takes a path argument. That's basically an address, and it returns the name of your file or folder. If that name isn't found, then DIR returns an empty string. Now, the attributes argument is optional, and they're basically the ones that are listed here. Default is VB normal, which are files with no specific attributes. Now, you could filter for specific attributes like read-only files or filter specifically for folders by using the constants that are listed here. One thing that comes in handy here, and we're going to see that in a second, is that we can use wildcards for the path argument. For example, you can use the asterisk sign or the multiplication operator as a wildcard that changes size. Basically, it represents a placeholder for any text that can come in between. Another wildcard you can use is the question mark. This one represents a fixed length string. If you use it once, it means just one character can be variable. So just one character can be anything. So that was the theory. Let's take a look at an example. This video is brought to you by Unlock Excel VBA, a macros course. So if you'd like to learn VBA in a structured way from the ground up, I suggest you check out the complete course. You're going to find the link in the description below the video or in the YouTube cards provided. So we're going to do two tasks here. Task number one is to see how we can use the DIR function to check if a file exists. If it doesn't exist, we're going to give the user a message telling them that this file does not exist. And if it does exist, we could, for example, open that file. In task number two, we're going to check if a folder exists. Now, if it doesn't exist, we will prompt the user with a message box asking them whether they want to create that folder. And if they say yes, we're going to create the folder for them. So let's switch to VB, Alt F11. I've already created an empty module here, and we're going to start with our first sub called file exists. So remember, the DIR function returns a name, and that name is the string, so we can declare a variable for that. I'm going to actually use file name. Okay, that can be any name you give it. I normally go with file name for these as string. Then we're going to do file name equals. So since this is a normal data type, it's not an object, we don't need the set keyword. And we're going to go with DIR. Now, DIR is also in the VBA global library, so you can get to it like this. Its specific compartment is called the file system class, so you can also get to it like this. I'm going to give it this path name. Okay, then I'm going to close brackets, so I'm just going to go with the default VB normal. Now, if this doesn't exist, we're going to get an empty string, right? So we can check for that and say if file name equals VB null string. Now, we can also get to this through IntelliSense by going to vba.constants.vb null string. Let's do an end if here. Then we want to inform the user that the file does not exist. Okay, so the moment this string is empty, it means file does not exist. Else, now as a first step, let's just get the file name. Once we see that this works, we're going to actually open that file. Okay, so let's run this and we get the file name back. Okay, so that's the file that I have in this directory. Now let's just use wildcards here as well. So if I do S2_ and I'm going to put star sign here. And for the last one, let's actually use the question mark here. Instead of the message box, let's open that file. We're going to do workbooks.open. Now we need the full path name. Actually going to be this. And the full file name, which is now our file name variable. Okay, so let's just check that folder, what we have on there. Okay, so That's the VBA folder. I have this S2 sitting here. Now let's run this and see if it opens our file. And our file is opened. Now let's move on to the second task, where we're going to check if a folder exists. And if it doesn't exist, we're actually going to create that folder. Here we can declare two variables. We can declare the variable called path. That's going to include the entire path together with the folder name. And we can declare the variable called folder, which is just going to be our folder name. Okay, now we can define these. So path equals, let's just work with this folder. And I'm going to add in a folder that doesn't exist in the VBA folder. So backslash, let's call it S12. Now folder is going to equal DIR, our path, okay, which is this one here. And since this is a folder, it's VB directory. Now we need to check if this is empty or not, right? Because if it's empty, it means it doesn't exist. So if folder equals VB null string, then let's do an endif here. Now right here, we want to give the user the opportunity to create the folder. So we're going to ask them with a message box whether they want to create that folder or not, and allow them to click on yes or no. So it's best here if I create a variable to keep the user's answer in. So I'm going to dim answer as VB message box result. And inside here, we're going to do answer equals message box. And we're going to ask them if they want to create it. Then we're going to give them the options to click on yes or no. And let's just give this a title, create path question mark. Now let's check their answers. This time I'm going to use the select case statement. So select case answer, and let's do end select here. So case is VB yes. Then we want to make or create this directory. And the function for that is mkdir. This one again is in the global library, so you can get to it like this, or to the file system class. Okay, and it needs one argument, and that one argument is the path, which includes the folder name. And it's a good coincidence because we've also called our variable path, so we can go with that. Now, for no, or let's just do case else, we just want to exit the sub. Right? So in case the folder doesn't exist, they're going to get this prompt. But if the folder does exist right now, we're not informing them in any way. The macro is just going to exit. So we could give them some information. And just before we do our endif, we can add an else, add a message box saying folder exists. Okay, so S12 does not exist on here yet, so we should be getting that message box. Okay, let's test. Path does not exist. Would you like to create it? Yes. Okay, now let's just double check. S12 is there. So let's run this again, see if we see that folder exists. So this is how you can use the DIR function to check whether a file or a folder exists. And depending on the outcome, you can decide what you want to do in your code.